Hey, what are you drinking? Is this the Marlboro soda?
Yes, I got it from a traditional store.
When it comes to traditional store, it makes me feel nostalgic. My parents used to take me there when I was a kid.
But recently, we almost can't see traditional store anymore. So today our topic is preserve our childhood memories, transformation, suggestion for traditional stores.
We divided our presentation into six parts: introduction, relevance resources, methods, findings and discussion, conclusion and references. Let's begin with introduction. In the past, traditional stores could be found everywhere. However, convenience stores recently has been swinging up due to the fast economic growth, which causes traditional stores to face their decline. So, to prevent traditional stores from disappearing, we apply the business knowledge and propose improvement methods for them.
These are our research questions. First, how do consumer preferences influence traditional stores? Second, what are the strengths and weaknesses between traditional stores and convenience stores? Thirdly, what could be done to help create business opportunities for traditional stores? Next, relevant resources. In introduction to business, we learn business operation and SWOT analysis. In industry projects, we learn how to find a suitable topic and organize data. In design for change, we discuss the idea of SDGs and learn traditional stores are confronting the dilemmas, including being replaced by emerging shops and labor techniques to transform themselves. In the application of digital technology, we learn how to make questionnaires and trust by using Word and Excel. The next part is methods. Our participants include 27 males and 128 females. To understand the view of public, we design questionnaires and organize the responses. Besides, we also interview the owner of true traditional store through online meetings to deeply understand their opinions. Let's talk about findings and discussion. This brush shows reasons why participants want to shop at traditional store. The top reasons are low prices, still efficient goods, and near home. This question shows reasons why participants do not want to shop at traditional store. The top two reasons are no guaranteed quality of products, incomplete variety of products, and the ability to make a large number of purchases at once. It can be inferred that participants' willingness are related to the type of goods, price, and location.
This table is a SWOT analysis of traditional store and convenience stores. Based on the table, we found traditional stores have many unique trends, such as bridging human touch and selling nostalgic products. However, traditional stores are at a disadvantage in terms of product quality and diversity. And the owner also lack modern management concepts. As for the opportunity, with the growing popularity of online shopping platforms, the owner could choose diverse business channels and increase their visibility of goods online. In short, traditional store owners can use their strengths and opportunities to turn around their weaknesses and threats.
This chart shows some ways for increasing the visibility of traditional stores. The top three methods chosen by participants are promoting activities, official websites, and member film. It could be inferred that if traditional stores want to survive in this competitive market, they should develop diverse marketing strategies. In order to promote traditional stores, we try to adapt to approaches based on results. One of the methods is to upload the promotional video on YouTube and Instagram. We shot a video and dubbed it to illustrate the background, situation, difficulties, and features that traditional stores had, and then encourage people to visit these nostalgic places often.
Moreover, we created an Instagram account to upload posts about traditional stores, such as their origin and features. These are examples of the posts on Instagram. Through vivid words and photos, we introduce several specialty items of traditional stores in order to resonate with the general public more quickly. Let's move on to the conclusion. According to our findings, we found consumers' preferences have changed due to the emergence of convenience stores. Although traditional stores have some advantage, there's still room for improvement. Also, the respondents suggest that traditional stores can change their decoration and boost their reputation by holding programming activities. Hence, we propose
First, choosing the shopping environment. Traditional stores can set out lighting equipment, prepare the traffic flow, and customers will increase their willingness to visit. Second, improving business concepts, such as attending courses or training sessions. The final part is promotion, including setting up an official account on social media, integrating online shopping platforms, and corporate activities.
Last but not least, we hope our promotional method and suggestion can be helpful to preserve this precious culture in everyone's memories.
Let's preserve the past for the future!
These are references. Thanks for listening.